Hello, Dr. Gary Namy. Let's talk about the insanity of the innocent and the smart among us being abused at a higher level. You know, workplace bullying is an upside-down world. You ask yourself, how can this be? I'm the veteran worker. I'm the go-to person, the one who knows the job better than anyone else, the one to whom all new employees are sent if they want to learn to do it right. And I just want to be left alone to do my work. All targets say that. Well, there's the rub, you see. Your tormentor's goal is opposed to yours, and it has absolutely nothing to do with work. It's all about her or his personal agenda, a day filled with game playing, if you will. Their goal is to disrupt, distort, and sabotage you, and to inflict what Heinz Lehmann, the international founder of the movement, called social misery. Now, you see, there are two opposing sets of expectations at work here. Yours, which is a rational way of believing things, is if I work really hard and up to the level of my competence, I'll be rewarded. Unfortunately, the bully's expectation, which is irrational and is responsible for turning the work world upside down, is it's my job to command and control other people. They're subhuman, if you will, and it requires a systematic campaign of interpersonal destruction to get them to do what they really should be doing. Now, HR discounts this inherent violence in the workplace as a, quote, personality conflict, or, quote, a clash in styles. That's why they tell you to go work it out among yourselves, because they don't want to own up to any organizational responsibility for putting you in harm's way. So in short, as a competent person, you pose a threat to the artificial, narcissistic identity that the bully has manufactured for him or herself. The WBI 2003 study, which you can find at our website's research section, has identified the top four attributes of a target. They are, number one, you're independent, you're feisty, you refuse to be subservient and be someone's slave. That really sets the bully off. Factor two is you're actually technically more skilled. Also, factor three, you're also well-liked. You have social skills, you have emotional intelligence. In fact, you're the one with the empathy for the bully. You're ethical and honest. All whistleblowers are bullied, without a doubt, but not everyone who's bullied is clearly a whistleblower. It is a crazy upside-down world, and it doesn't make sense, and it's not fair, and it's not just. You can read more about this and all the other topics about workplace bullying in our book, The Bully at Work. Please visit the WBI website at workplacebullying.org and tell your friends about us. Thank you.